Hello students, good morning. In the previous video, I have taught you the first poem of your English chapter, that is On the Bridge. Okay, in today's class we are going to learn a new lesson, that is The Visit to the Mansion. Okay, The Visit to the Mansion, and the author of this lesson is Louisa May Alcott. Okay. Chapter 2, The Visit to the Mansion. So, first of all, we'll know about the author. Okay. Louisa May Alcott was one of the most renowned American authors of her time. Okay, her most famous novel, Little Women, was based on her childhood with her three sisters. Alcott's family, just like the March family, faced financial difficulties. Okay, so Alcott had to work from an early age to support her family. Writing became a way for her to express her emotions and creativity. Okay, so now we will start the lesson. Okay. Jo March sometimes stood before her old brown house and looked at the stately mansion of the Lawrences. She knew that only old Mr. Lawrence and his grandson Laurie lived there, but to her the mansion seemed to be an enchanted palace filled with the delightful things. She longed to see them. Befriend Laurie, who looked very lonely and shy. So she decided to visit the Lawrence mansion and tell Mr. Lawrence to allow Laurie to leave the house and play. Okay, so what's the meaning of mansion here? So, large, impressive house. Okay, so Joe is the girl here. Okay, and March is the surname, like how you'll have your surnames, no? In the same way, Jo is a girl and March is her surname. And Mr. Lawrence is the old grandfather of Laurie. Laurie is a boy here. Laurie is a boy living with his grandfather Lawrence. Okay, so Jo used to stand at the window and she used to look from the window to a old brown house, which was a mansion. Okay, Laurie used to live in there, but to her, the mansion seemed to be an enchanted palace. She used to think that the mansion was very enchanted place, filled with good things. Okay, she longed to see them. She loved to see them and she wanted to make Laurie as her friend. Okay, who used to be very lonely and shy. Laurie is a very lonely and shy boy. So she decided to visit the Lawrence. So what she decided? She decided to meet Laurie's grandfather. Okay, Laurie's grandfather Lawrence, and tell him that to make Laurie allow him out of the house and to play. Okay, one snowy afternoon, Jo saw Mr. Lawrence drive off. She set out towards the mansion and looked around. It was completely quiet. So one day, what happened? One snowy afternoon, okay, as you can see in the picture, no, Joe is standing in the house and she is looking at the mansion. She was seeing that Mr. Lawrence drive off. He had taken the car and he's been driving off. So she set out towards the mansion and looked around. When she entered into the mansion, the place was very quiet. Okay, suddenly she spotted a curly head leaning against a desk at an upper window. There he is, thought Joe. Poor boy, I'll toss up a snowball and make him look out. So what Joe had entered into the mansion, and when suddenly she spotted a curly head leaning against a desk. Okay, so at an upper window, she thought that she can see a head leaning out from the window. So then what she thought, there he is, poor boy, I'll toss up a snowball. So then she did a ball with the snow and she had tossed him up. Okay, so up went a ball of snow and the head turned at once. Laurie peeped out, eyes bright with wonder. When he spotted Joe, he began to smile. So when Joe has tossed up the ball, Laurie was leaning against the desk, no? So what he did, he had turned his face at once. And Laurie, what he did, he came to the window and he peeped out from the window. What's the meaning of peeped out? Looking out from the window. His eyes bright with wonder. So he was thinking, who was that? When he spotted Joe, he began to smile. When he had seen Joe from down, he started smiling. Joe called out, how do you do? Are you sick? So what happened? Joe called out, how do you do? Are you feeling sick? Okay, Laurie croaked hoarsely. I had a bad cold and it's very dull here. Will you come upstairs and talk to me, please? Okay, then when Joe asked him, how do you do? So Laurie croaked hoarsely, means spoke in a deep, harsh voice that he cannot talk. Okay, I had a bad cold and it's very dull here. So he's asking to Joe to come upstairs and talk to him. Okay, then I'll ask mother, wait. So what happened in the meanwhile? He asked and came off excited. Okay, so we'll continue the story in the next session, and your assignment is to read the lesson and to underline the new words. Thank you.